Hello everybody, this is Chris, and in this video I am going to show you how to track a shot without tracking points using Mocha for After Effects. So many of us like to track shots to add elements into the shot, and we might not always have tracking points. You can use a camera tracker program to create a 3D tracking point, or if you have a shot that generally is just in a two-dimensional translation, you don't go forward or back, you just move left or right, up and down, and so forth. You don't actually move or zoom in and zoom out. So you can use Mocha for After Effects to do that. Which is really good if there's a lot of motion blur, because tracking points with a lot of motion blur is hard to do. It's practically impossible to do. So with Mocha for After Effects, you can track. It's a planar tracker rather than a point tracker, so you can track a texture, so to speak, rather than a point. So let's go into After Effects and see how it's done. Here I am in After Effects. You can, in After Effects CC 2014, you can use every version of After Effects, recent version, that is CS5, it's in a different spot, CS6 and above, it'll be under the animation, and you can track in Mocha AE. However, you have to do a few things first. You can't simply import your video in there and track it. You have to export the video out in an image sequence, re-import it back into After Effects, and then use Mocha for AE. So what you're going to do is import your footage. So I'm going to go to File, Import, File. I had to convert it from the AVI to the MP4 because it didn't import properly the AVI for some reason. I don't know if it's the way my camera records AVIs or not. I do want to get a new camera eventually that records some better quality footage, like a GoPro. However, not to get too sidetracked, we're going to import our footage, import. Drop it into a new comp. Alright, and you can see our footage here where I move back and forth. So I'm going to go to comp, add to render queue, do best settings, best full, and change this to like PG and PNG sequence or JPEG sequence. I'm going to do JPEG sequence with a maximum quality and hit OK. Go in here. And I'm going to just copy the footage folder so we don't have to browse. All right, and image. Sequence. I'm going to do IS. So it's just image sequence. And then we're going to save. Then we're just going to render it out. Now once we have rendered out our sequence, we're going to go back to File, Import, File, go into our image sequence, select it, make sure this is checked if you're in Adobe CC. It's not in CS6, but it should. There should be an option to check image sequence or so forth. And you just make sure if there's a sequence, since it is a sequence, to make sure that you check the sequence setting before you import it, otherwise it'll just import that one frame. So we'll bring it in. We want to adjust it to what our footage is. So our footage was 30 frames per second, which is the default, 30 frames a second. So now we're going to have this selected, go up to animation, track in Mocha AE. All right, and so now we have new project. Make sure our frames and everything is proper, you know, all squared away and everything. Then we're going to hit OK. As you can see, as I scrub through here, you can see our sequence. It plays a lot faster here because it's an image sequence and stuff. So, next what you want to do is take the X form spline layer tool and in a shot like this, you really don't have to worry about a lot of things since we're going to be tracking the shot. There's nothing in the shot to really worry about messing with the track. So I want to take and track this area. Okay, and right click to get rid of the track. All right, it's not tracked yet. So what you want to do is then go down here to track and track forward. Or you can go frame by frame if you want. But since this shot is relatively simple, we can probably track forward all the way through automatically without worrying about points going off. So I'm going to hit track forward. Now, the larger the area you track, the slower the track will go. The smaller it is, the faster the track will go. But if you get a lot of motion blur, it may present problems for tracking. So make sure you select a reasonable area for your particular footage. If it's a very simple shot where there's no motion or anything in terms of 3D space, where it's just panning X and Y rather than Z, you will be able to use this two-dimensional planar tracking to track your shot, even if you don't have any track points, because it'll track the contrasted texture areas, as you can see here. All right, as you can see, we got a really good track here. And you can see even here, I didn't realize the shot was as long as it was. But after this, you need to bring the slider all the way back to the beginning. Hit export tracking data. The format you want is After Effects Transform Data. Copy to clipboard. Go back into After Effects, and I want to switch this to the PNG sequence rather than the video so we get a little bit smoother playback. Go to New, Null Object. Then you're going to go Edit, Paste. And now you can see it pastes all the keyframes in here. Now you can copy the anchor point, copy, paste. Then you can uncheck the anchor point and change it to 0, 0. So we have the null at our tracking point the whole time, as you can see. And you can see it follows our shot really nicely. All right. So then, you know, for simplicity, since I don't have anything to use, I'm going to create a solid. And I'm just going to make it, you know, just some color. All right, then I'm going to scale it down. And then I'm going to pick whip it to the null object. So now when we track through the shot, that solid or whatever you're linking to the null will be tracked to that null object. Even the rotation. So as we get down here to where I start rotating the camera, you can see the solid rotates with it, as you can see. And the good thing about this is you can add motion blur to this layer by turning on motion blur and then motion blur for the comp. Now you can't really see it because it's not moving very quickly. However, as I scrub through here, you can see the motion blur on this solid. You can't do motion blur for the null, obviously, because it's a null object. However, you can see the motion blur on our layer here. So you can pretty much match the motion blur of your footage. If it's not moving a lot, you won't see any motion blur. But in a shot like this where there's some motion blur, in fact, it's really hard to notice in my video because of the quality that there's motion blur. However, if I was moving the camera faster, you'd be able to see motion blur. So that's how you use Mocha for AE to planar track your footage. Now you can't go crazy with your footage and expect it to work. at least as far as I know, because I don't use Mocha for AE to track footage a lot. In fact, at all, really. So, but if you have a simple shot, you know, in my Star Wars animation video, to get that last shot of the Falcon flying over the camera, I actually used Mocha for AE to track the footage from that, so that the Falcon would, I could link it to a null in the After Effects comp, and it would move with that footage, because the footage does have a slight movement to it. And so without it, the Falcon kind of moved off the footage, but since it was tracked to the footage with the null Mocha AE tracking, the layers for the Falcon moved with the footage, which allowed it to blend it nicely in with the footage.